Sweeping up all that construction dust. It's crazy, there's a lot of dust in here. Let me finish that up. Just think about it, all that dust is on the layout too. This room used to be like a clean room until construction. Not anymore.
At switching hour, time is up. My hour is done in the train room.
Well, check that out. Is that pretty cool? It is clean. Still need some more prep work for paint. I'm gonna start working on the bench work probably later at the end of this week to kind of clear all that stuff up. Prep up there for paint. But I'm doing pretty good. I'm pretty proud of myself within an hour. But I still have to work on this side of the room. I'm pretty much just organizing now, boxing stuff up as you can see, but it's getting better. Don't forget to comment down below. I do read your comments. I might not reply to them today, but I will reply to them. Also, check out all the links that are provided below and check out the secret Amazon link. See what I'm looking at on Amazon. Who knows what it could be? It's a mystery. Check it out. Click on it and see. This wasn't planned at all, but it looks like we're going to have an impromptu mail call, so I'll roll that RPO splash screen. So this is a question from Roy Hardwick. Just set up a whole bunch of live streaming cameras. You know what? I actually thought about that at one point, but we have a couple situations. My wife comes in this room, my kids come in this room. I'd have to remember to turn them off. I used to be a really good swimmer. I had a body of, you know, like, I don't know, Hercules, whatever you call it now. I do come in this room without a shirt on. I now look more like E.T. without a shirt. So I'm pretty sure you guys don't want to see that. So I don't know if I want to live stream them, but I do have live stream cameras. I have two of them. We use them to watch the dogs when we're on vacation. The problem is, now that I'm kind of out of work, I've cut back my internet service way back to about base level. So I only have, I believe it's like a 1 gigabyte upload. It's like the lowest level you can get. So I do not know how well it will take, will live streaming work. It takes, just to upload a video now, it takes about 2 to 3 hours to upload a video when it used to take about 5 minutes or less. So that's a huge difference, but cost savings, I can't have all the fancy stuff anymore. But I do appreciate that question. Now look into that. I also might be looking into that YouTube live stream stuff. We might try some live stream stuff too. Who knows? But either way, thanks for that question. That was a great question. Here's a question from RPM750. And by the way, Baja is spelled with a J, not an H. Just so you know. Basically, he's wondering if I'm going to work on the Baja pretty much. Get the Baja out and do the dunes. Your VW bro. RPM750. I need to go out and actually fix the rear suspension and the front suspension. I actually kind of messed it up last time I was out with it. Not a big deal, pretty much a couple day fix, but I'm actually going to do that. I probably feature that on one of my other YouTube channels, which I have, probably AZ Baja or maybe my I'm a Dad channel. I'll provide those links over here. The dust. And I do appreciate all the comments about the job situation. As you guys know, I do have 3 kids, and I've been kind of looking for a job, but the job has to pay more than it costs to put those kids in daycare. When I worked at Intel, I worked at night, so I kind of watched the kids during the daytime hours. But now if I work during the daytime, daycare ends up being $350, $400 per kid per month for getting them off the bus and everything. So if you start doing the math, some jobs aren't worth it. I'll actually be losing money to go to work. So that's kind of a parent situation. Lisa does have a job and she's doing really well, so that kind of covers those bases. Hey, but thank you for asking that question. Now, I don't know what people are doing watching my videos, but someone spotted that in the video and wanted to know what in the world that is. Well, it's a set of parts. I don't have all of them there. It's for moving coffins. Or in my case, pinball machines. It's not really a coffin mover. That plank right here goes inside the van. And if you look, it's got a set of wheels on there. So what I do is I set the pinball machine right behind the van. I locate that first set of wheels inside the van and lift kind of like a wheelbarrow. I can take all 4 legs off. And once all the legs are off, you roll the pinball machine into the van. And that's what it is. It's for getting the pinball machines in and out of the van. You will not believe how heavy they are, but that's what that is. I was like, Why would somebody ask me what that weird H-looking thing is with wheels on it? Well, that's what it is. It's pretty much kind of like moving a coffin. I use, some guys that own pinball machines actually use coffin lifts to move their pinball machines. I have a hydraulic cart I use to move mine. But just getting them in and out of a vehicle like the van, you have to get something to slide them all the way in. They're rather heavy, but that's what that is. So, ask me train questions. Don't ask me about lumber looking things on the side of the video.
One more thing, I'm doing okay. But don't forget Sparky107107. Check out his link right here. He has a furnace problem. If you don't know about that, go over to, I think it's Go Via or Go Home. I'll put his link right there. He has a contest going on. You can donate $5. On his contest, it's $10 or whatever you guys feel like. Just help Sparky107107 out. I mean, a furnace is a furnace. So either way, I will talk to you guys later. Thanks for sticking with me, and if you like this video and my other videos, find that thumbs up button down below, and you know the drill, thumbs up.